Welcome to Shelf Centered. Thanks again for stopping by. I know I did at the end of July, I did a monthly update, and I just so many things have changed in literally the last week. I was like, I at least need to do some kind of weekly update. So we're gonna call this because we gotta get ourselves centered, all right? Shelf Centered, that's the name of the game. We're going to center the shelf. We're centering the shelf. That's what an update is. We got to get centered. And so with that being said, I know I'm a genius. You could tell me about it in the comments. You don't have to, but if you're dying to, I get it. So just the last time I did an update, holy cow, I was just rewatching the video and things have changed a bit, just slightly. So, literally last week I was celebrating 100 subs and 100 subscribers and 1,000 views. And literally it's not even been a week later and we're up, as it says here, in the last 28 days, I'm up 260 subscribers. So that's we're up to 297 subscribers as long as nothing changes between now and when this gets posted in about 12 hours. So, wow. And then on top of it, 2,096 views. Literally 1 week later, that's what I was celebrating. That is in large part thanks to a lot of the friends I've made, Andrew's Wizardly Reads, David DeCero, Raul Reads, Patrick. Holy cow, all you Patrick fans, thank you so much for checking out my channel. But literally the last update video at the end of last month, and it's not even halfway through this month, I was talking about having a little over 60 subscribers and almost 2,000 views. Like, holy cow, it's just crazy. Let's see, this week, just to kind of look at the week that we've had, we've done a couple of reviews. We've got the Sandman review and Off to Be a Wizard review, two audiobooks that I had listened to relatively recently. I really love me a good self-published independent press book. I hope I came off, the goal was to say it's just as good as traditional. Some people have this in their head that it's not. I wanted to say that is false. I was literally trying to show this is a great option. Traditional published people do this. All kinds of, people go in and out. I think it's a great thing. Fans can get stuff honestly at the author's kind of schedule instead of the publisher's, which can be very different schedules, right? Anyway, I honestly didn't think that video would do as well as it has done, and it has done quite well for this channel. You got to keep perspective, and I'm hitting lights again. So as far as that goes, like that, and you always have that in your head of, oh, if I post about self-published works, are the traditional publishers going to hate me? I don't know why I even, there's that momentary, and then I'm like, wait a sec. I don't really care. Who cares? But at the same time, what's great is literally the same day or the day after or something right around there, I got an email from Tor asking if I wanted to review one of their books. So it's like, yeah, they don't care. They're just happy to say, hey, what about ours too? But this is in the August, okay? So shut up. That's what I'm talking about. But then don't shut up next month because I love your books tour, so there you go. Top video, Malazan video still killing it, most viewed by far. One of the surprises, I guess it shouldn't be a surprise, top 10 anything is kind of, I mean that's kind of what brought me to the internet and fantasy, being honest, was I was looking for more great books to read and I thought, why not start with the best? And started searching top 10, and actually that's how I found SFF World, which is a great site. It was a forum, well, it is a forum, and just a great community of great people. So that's top 10s are great. I love it, but that's really done well. And of course, the 100 subs video is done well with the giveaway. When I forced everyone to like and subscribe and to be able to enter, I actually If the giveaway winner is watching, please contact me. I'm trying to get a hold of the giveaway winner still. I may have to give a timeline and then say, all right, I need to pick a new winner. So, with someone who will get back to me. So, I would hate to do that. I want to give it to the winner, fair and square, you know. But I want to give it to someone. I don't want to just be like, well, I guess I don't have to pay any money or anything. Hey, I said I would do it and I want to do it. I can't wait to do it. This is what this is all about, is sharing the
You know,
love.
I was doing these kind of deals videos, and I was like, maybe this is a good transition where I can go from specific deals videos to maybe just like a weekly, hey, if I find any deals, throw them in here. This doesn't need to be its own thing. So one of the deals I saw was Binti by Nnedi Okorafor. The whole trilogy is $1.99 right now. Link in the description. Boom. And I just heard nothing but good things about her work. I still need to. Who Fears Death? Is that the one? That's on my list. I need to get to that sooner rather than later. Let's see. I wanted to talk about my anticipated releases that are coming up for this year, and some that are just I kind of like either anticipated releases or books that I've just been kind of having my eye on. Just what's sparking my interest recently and what am I excited about? I think that can be many things. It can be things that are literally available this second and things that are not quite available and things that are older and just that's what sparked my interest. So that's what you get here. I'm getting sassy today. I don't know why. We're full of sass. The biggest, I think, for me, The God Is Not Willing by Steven Erickson. I do feel like I have a number of books that I want to read ahead of time, but shoot, if suddenly it popped up in a bookstore and I bought it, I don't know if I can help myself. The Maleficent Seven by Cameron Johnston is really, I mean, just people are like, it's like pirates and vampires and I'm like, you almost already have me alone with that. Another one that I saw, I think this isn't like an extremely new one. It's Phoenix Extravagant by Yoon Ha Lee. Awesome. Ciao. Looking really good. Billy Summers, I'm a little worried. Some of it's kind of got mixed reviews right now. Stephen King's newest, because of course he'll have two in a year and he's in his 70s and he's just throwing books out left and right. Billy Summers, I just worry. I'm like, we just had The Sixth Sense. Now we got John Wick. Is that, are we really, we're just like, hey, what's the latest movie? I know he's been going through his like movies he hadn't watched, and he's like, now I'm writing about these. On one hand, interesting. I kind of like, hey, let's have a Stephen King take on things. Really good characters doing the things that I liked in the movies sounds great. At the other end, you're going, what about the original great ideas? And I don't know, maybe if that's what it's got to be, it's got to be. I'll take it, I guess. The Necessity of Rain by Sarah Chorn. It looks really good. The cover art, you got to see it. There you go. And it just things she writes are amazing, so that's good stuff. And then Season of Albaldone by Ilan Marche and Christopher Warman. Am I getting any close at all? That also really good. I've read really good or seen really good reviews on that. Gotta read it. It's on the list. Let's do.
Let's see. Now for movies and TV, I think you know the biggest for me, maybe if I haven't been clear on it in the ch on the channel, Dune's coming up. I mean, doesn't it look amazing? And then Wheel of Time. Those are really ones that I'm really looking forward to. I honestly haven't paid attention too much with this whole virus situation. It's hard to I don't know. It's hard to get into movies. And honestly, the main movies that I watch are like either old movies that I love and keep rewatching or the newest Pixar or whatever that comes out. The was it Raya and the Last Dragon? That was pretty good. My kids loved it. So that's what I'm watching, and I'm okay with it. channel future. We want to look at the future. Future of the channel. What are we looking at? I got some plans. I've been trying to get together just some ideas for some videos. I have a huge list going, but one of the ones that I want to hit, like I said at the top of the video, is top 10s. I really love a good top 10 list. I promise it's not just for the views. But it honestly is because I love talking top 10s. I love hearing other people's top 10s. I love giving my top 10s. And what's funny is I'm actually, it's so weird. I've been like, okay, I can do a top 10 of the year. That's easy enough. But my like all-time top 10 is like scaring me. So am I crazy? Probably. But I've kind of got divisions into top 10 fantasy, top 10 sci-fi, top 10 weird. I know I've been talking about that lately. Top 10 standalone books, top 10 series. I've been trying to just narrow some things down. Another one I want to do is just ranking series, like The Dark Tower. I've got it ranked already, so I'm ready to go. That one's raring to go. I'm ready for that one. I want to rank The Dark Tower, my favorite Dark Tower books. Maybe just rank all Stephen King books that I've ever read. Tier lists, I guess. That's where we're at. That's what's going on. All right. So, what do we got next? You know, I think we need to do a little bit of Today in Mispronouncing Fantasy Names. Today's name is Bokoral. Any guesses? It's probably an easy one. I'll be honest, there's gonna be a well I will go to over and over again. So you're probably good guessing into that well if you know what Bokoral is. Barkeral, broccoli. I'm laughing at how not funny I am. I hope that was clear. All right. Okay. Hey, thanks for subscribing, liking, doing your thing. You are awesome. Appreciate it. We'll see you next time.